The following is a conversation with His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on January 9, 1977, in Bombay, India.
We have got so many advancements, the nuclear energy and everything, but why you cannot give life to the machine stock? Why?
There's no soul in it.
Huh?
There's no soul in it.
That is the fact we know. We know that is fact. That, my point is that the modern age, they are very much proud of advanced technology. So where is that knowledge? And why people do not tax their brain to get this knowledge? This is very important subject matter, but where is that knowledge? And why they do not try to do it? We get information from the Supreme Personality of Godhead that this jiva, the driver, not driver, the passenger, we are passenger. Driver is God, and machine made by material energy, maya. Janta Rurhani Maya. The similarity is there. The motor car is manufactured by somebody. And the passenger is there, and the driver is there. Similarly, this is a machine made by Maya. I am the passenger, and God is driver. Ishara Sarabhutana, Riddhesha Arjunati, Brahmayan is driver. The passenger or the owner is asking, Mr. Driver, you go this way. So he's driving. Just like the same, Arjuna is asking Krishna, Srinayar Ubhar Madde Ratasthapayam Echu. Just between these two parties of soldiers, please keep my chariot. The same thing, the chariot driver, he is the super soul. In this body, there are two souls. Ketrangan chapri mang vidhi, sarva ketresu bhara. That he is also Ketrangan. Ketra is his body. And Ketrangan, who knows this body? This I know. It is my finger. I never say I finger, it is my finger. So, similarly the driver also can say, it is my car, and the proprietor also can say. So two persons, one driver and one passenger, or the proprietor. And the body is machine. The subjects are there. Why? You do not try to understand this subject matter. Then what is your advancement? That is my challenge. Why you are so much proud of your advancement of knowledge? What is this knowledge? Tell me, you are a young man. I am giving you the challenge. Either you admit that you are not advanced or make advancement. Why you set aside this difficult subject matter and become proud by making a small machine that you are advanced? When is your advance? Only Bhagavadji Aapko be technology. He is Mr. Bajaj, the proprietor of the Bajaj Electricity.
You know each other.
Maharaj,
In the context of the universe, the technological and scientific advancement is very, very insignificant. But as far as human beings are concerned, they feel that they have achieved great deeds.
Why? We cannot give life.
Because there is a change from the past. So they feel that there is a difference. That is at a very low level of
that is my point. That you are becoming so much proud of your technology.
Yes.
But what we have
done... Which is very insignificant.
Yes, that is my point. Why you become falsely proud that you have done so advanced man, that you don't care for God, don't care for the original manufacturer. That is your fault.
The other day there was a doctor who had come from America for transplantation of kidney. And he had given a lecture in the Rotary Club. I was there. Now, they give so much importance to the person who is able to transplant kidney from one body to the other. But how about the whole human being or the universe which has been created by God? Now, this is just a very, very insignificant thing which is already there, which is just transplantation. But they feel so happy and proud. I mean, what you are
saying
is
my point.
The same point.
Falsely proud.
Are they able to increase the life by a single moment?
Because
after they say they have achieved so much, are they able to increase it by even a single moment?
No.
When they say all,
this,
now nothing is in our hands.
This breathing is given there that you must breathe so many million times, must finish. Just like you wind the watch,
yes.
It will run or go round so many times. As soon as we finish, then stop.
It's unwound, it is finished.
The energy is limited. So by the yogic process they increase because they stop breathing. Breathing is limited. Just like you have got bank balance, 200,000. If you don't spend, there is immense.
But you got to breathe.
No.
You cannot stop
breathing. Yogic process, you can stop breathing.
Stop breathing or lengthen it.
Stop breathing means you don't spend. You have got a limited breathing period. By yogic process, you stop breathing, but you remain. That is mystic yoga. So similarly, you can simply increase your life by not using the breathing process. That is pranayama. That is pranayama. So, but you cannot exceed the limit. That is not possible. Similarly, we are suffering in this material world. The covering is there because we wanted to transgress the laws of God. Krishna bhuliya jeeva bhogavan chakare. When we forget our relationship with Krishna, that Krishna is the original master, and I am the servant, as soon as we forget this relationship, this is contamination. Immediately. Everyone is trying to become another Krishna. This is struggle. Here in this material you will find everyone is trying to become very, very big. Big leader, big politician, big businessman, big. But he is not big. That is the disease. He is not big and he is trying to become big.
See, a corona, if you have a gene and it keeps going, they can really create havoc. Artificial development.
What is that?
It says Dr. Karana. He's made a gene.
Gene?
Gene
viewing cell.
Yes, they take
the
hereditary qualities that a person inherits is determined by these genes. So now they're thinking that if they can control the genes, they can create their own type of human being according to their own
They can. that this nonsense speaking is going on throughout the history, but they will never get it. That is a fact. We are trying, we shall do in future, these things are going on. And these are stories. We don't believe in these nonsense things. They will never get it. That is not possible. Therefore I challenge your technology. Where is that department? Do it. First of all, do it. Suppose if a man is in business, he may say that I am trying to become a millionaire. But he cannot say that I am a millionaire. So the so-called scientist, yes, we are trying. If you are trying, that's all right. But when you become, then you call scientist. And there is no possibility, and because you are trying, you have to accept your scientist. There, recently, in California University, one professor came. He has gained the Nobel Prize in chemical evolution. They are trying to prove that life is generated by chemical evolution. So, in that meeting, I and my one student, is Dr. Swarup Damodar. He is also a big chemist. So he knows, he talks with me, he has got the idea. He has written one book, Scientific Basis of Krishna Consciousness. So he challenged, that suppose if I give you the chemicals, can you produce life? The answer, that I cannot say. Why he talks nonsense? He is theorizing that life is made of chemicals, but if you give the chemicals, why you cannot make life? When I was in South Africa, or is that Pretoria or something?
Yeah.
There are many factories for chicken killing, chicken incubator. So one of the students there, workers there, I said, suppose this is a chicken factory, so take one egg and analyze the chemicals. There is some white substance, yellow substance, it is covered with some cell. You can do it and put that in the incubator and get a chicken. Why don't you do that? The rascal could not answer. Don't talk of big life. Make a chicken. And these rascals cannot do that. And still they will talk big words. What do you think? Are they not rascals? These rascals, they talk in big words. First of all, prove. Make one egg. Then talk of big brain. Make one egg. It is, everyone can see there are some white chemicals and some yellow chemicals and it is covered. And you analyze and combine the chemical in the same way and put it in the incubator and get one chicken. What? Your technology say, why they cannot? And when they cannot do it, why they talk so big words? Mislead others and mislead himself.
No, they feel so proud because
God's
creation is so huge, vast and unfathomable.
That
they are able to unravel even a small part of it, which was not known to human beings beforehand. So they are so proud. They don't say that they can
It is not. Krishna says, Omai Bhanga Jiva. This life is my part and parcel. As soon as you study what is this life, you understand Krishna. Quality, what is Krishna. So here is the hint. that, Krishna said, Mava Ivaamsa Jiva Rupa. So, it's a very small particle. That is also mentioned in the Shastra. Kesagra Sadavagasya Satadha Kalpitasya Jiva Bhagasya Vidya Sa Anantaya Kalpata. The measurement of soul is given there in the Shastra. 1/10,000 part of the tip of the hair. Everything is there. It is not matter. And that is instructed in the Bhagavad Gita. Lāyaṁ sastra acchiddayaṁ adājhayaṁ akledya asasayavati. This spiritual spark cannot be cut into this acchiddayaṁ adājhayaṁ. It cannot be burnt into the fire. So, but these rascals, they are saying that the body is burnt into ashes. So everything is finished. And Krishna said, adarchayam. It cannot be burnt. So it remains. And that transmigrates. And that small particle, you have no eyes to see. You say that, why shall I believe? Transmigration. How nature's law is working so subtle way. Prakitekriyamanani gunikarmani sarva. By the ahankara bhimura. I say rascal, not manufactured by me. Ahankara bhimura. Bhimura means a great rascal. Mura means rascal, ass. And be, vishesh, particularly first class ass. Bhimura. Under false pride, he is thinking, I am everything. Ahankara bhimura, katta aham nitim, I can do anything by science, by this technology. Bhimura, great rascals. And these great rascals, they are leading the world, therefore. People are in darkness. They have become leaders. The so-called scientists and educationists and political leaders, all set up rascals. And they have become leaders. Andhajathandhayirupaniyamana. They are blind and they are leading other blind men. So people are kept in darkness. And the opportunity of this human life is lost. By nature's way, by evolution process, we get this human form of life. Bhavunam janmanam ante. Manusha, arthadam. Prahlad Maharaj said, durlabham manusam janmanam. Such life, important life, they're wasting like cats and dogs. So this is education, this is advancement. People are not given the opportunity to utilize this valuable life for understanding higher things. This is the plight of this civilization. They are growing like cats and dogs and dying like cats and dogs. And tathādehāntara prāpti. And according to his work, he has to accept another body. That is nature's law. So in this life, I am a very big man, but my work, karmanā daivane trana, by superior administration, I have to accept a body of dog. Then what is the value of your being great now? That technology is unknown, although it is stated there in the world. Everything is. Tatha dehantara prapti. So Krishna never says that you will get such and such body. Dehantara, you will have to change the body. And suppose there are 8,400,000 different types of bodies. Suppose next time I become a tree. And just see, horrible position, here is a tree. I am in this room, sitting so comfortably, and the tree is standing there. I can get that life also. Karmana, by my work. So this technology is unknown. And we are very much proud of advancement. Boli. Am I right or wrong?
I don't know. I've never given very serious thought or considered it. I've never given very serious thought or considered it.
These are not the subject matter for serious thought. Do you think? You are under the grip of the laws of material nature. Do you admit on that? Then, why you should be under the grip of material nature? And if there is way, why should you not take? Māmi vaja prapadante māyā me tāng taranti. So, why you are trying to get better position? That should be the endeavor, that we may get better position.
Satsang?
That's satsang. Satāng prasanga. That's satsang. But we know that word only, but if we don't take advantage, then what is it?
Execution part is more important of the satsanga.
Yeah. Satsanga means which is true and not contaminated. That is sat, om tat sat. So satsanga means to associate with spiritual knowledge. That is satsanga.
And execution of this course?
Well, Sangha means execution. When you associate with medical association, share brokers association, simply go there and sit down is not your business. You have to do something. You have to do something. Satsang means that. Tadjosana asu abhavar kovartmani. Satsanga means you have to take the knowledge and use it for practical purpose. That is satsanga. So, our this Krishna consciousness movement is trying to give the satsanga opening centers all over the world. If people take advantage of it, they will benefit. But if he is ahankara vimuratma, then it is unfortunate. Mandasu mandamatayo mandohagya upadhyutta. This is Kali Yuga. The leaders also do not associate with sat, and they create their own imagination. Sat, Om Tat Sat, Bhagavan is the Supreme Sat. So they do not care for Bhagavan. So there is no satsanga, asatsanga. Satsanga chari koinu asate bilas. Te karane lagila mor karma bandho phas. I have given up satsanga and I am trying to enjoy asat. Asatoma sadgama, that is basic in Jnana. But I do not care for satsanga. Satsanga chari. You have to take up something after giving up something. So our present position is satsanga chari koinu asate bilas. I have given up satsanga and I am trying to enjoy in asana. The result is, I am entangled in karma-bandha-phasa. according to karma, I am changing my body, and today I am human being, and tomorrow I am a dog. And again from dog to another body, another body. This is my...
Sadgama.
Translation of it. That means try to come to the transcendental platform, sat, and don't remain in this asat. Asat means which is temporary.
And in tamasoma, jyotirgama.
Tamasoma, don't remain in the darkness. Come to the light. This is the basic injunction. But we don't take advantage of the instruction. We think that if I can make one table from ordinary wooden plank, that is advantage. This is technology. This nice polished table. It is a transformation of the crude wooden plank. So this crude wooden plank is transformed into a nice table, we see this is advanced. What is the actual benefit? I can do without this table. But we have taken this is advanced. Transforming the form of an element into another, that is advanced. The asati bilas, this is asat. This is either in crude form or in transformed form. So I am taking credit because a crude wood has been turned into a tape. So that is my bilas. So satsanga chari gainu asat bilas. So I am now bound up. So I can become a very nice carpenter. Does it mean that I am self-realized? If you learn the art of turning crude wood to a table, nice table, you may get the credit of becoming a nice carpenter. And that does not mean you are self-realized. They are taking credit of this turning crude wood into nice devil, and they think that our life is successful. This is right. And the real technology that I am not this body, I have been put into this condition and I am transmigrating from one body to another. There is no. Temporary thing, flickery thing, like children. Children is very busy on the beach making sand palaces. And he's very happy. So our position is like that. But we should be intelligent enough that that is our real life. Permanent life, not this temporary life. This life is temporary, there is another life. Na hannate hannamane sarire. This sarir is not avinashita tadviddhi jena sarvamidam tatam. So many things in Bhagavad Gita is full of information, but you don't take.